Stop Quickie. This isn't the first Quickie about why government doesn't do a good job with auto safety, but it is about arguably the worst example of it. Airbags. Airbags were originally invented for airplanes in 1919 and implemented in 1951. But the next year, 1952, it was invented for automobiles. But despite a lot of work being put into it by engineers in the US, Germany, and Japan, it wasn't ready for practical use until 1967, with the first models installed in 1973. But the airbag was invented as a supplemental restraint designed to protect someone wearing a seatbelt. Unfortunately, by this time, government was heavily regulating automobiles and insisted that airbags protect an unbelted passenger as well. GM in particular spent years lobbying against this requirement to no avail. This requirement had two negative effects. One, it delayed the implementation of airbags by over a decade, meaning that passengers were denied this life-saving feature in the interim. A lot of people who would have been saved by airbags died during that time, and they just didn't have to. In Europe, even more onerous regulations delayed airbags an additional 5 years. The second is, in order to protect an unbelted passenger, the airbag has to deploy more quickly, which necessitates it deploying with greater force. GM warned that this would be dangerous, if not fatal, to children and shorter occupants, and that warning proved to be very true. And by the way, they were required to put in these dangerous airbags starting in 1991. Of course, politicians and the news media blamed the free market and unfeeling corporations for those deaths. Because of course they did. But Congress and regulators refused to budge, not even willing to let drivers turn off their airbags if they determine it's too risky for them. The most they could get them to agree to was sensors to detect how forcefully the airbag could deploy. Seatbelt sensors, crash severity sensors, driver weight sensors, child seat sensors, seat position sensors, lots of them! In 1998, manufacturers were finally able, and of course, required, to deliver much safer airbags, but the technology required to do it ended up making cars more expensive as a result. Of course, not a single politician or regulator suffered the slightest recrimination for it. If they're not held accountable when they get it wrong, why should anyone trust them?